Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being here. I want to take an opportunity to discuss our office's role as special prosecutor in the ongoing investigation into the death of Ms. Breonna Taylor. I want to be clear at the outset of this conference that it's informational only. The investigation remains ongoing, and the specifics will not be discussed. But before I go on any further, I just want to say to Ms. Breonna Taylor's family how I continue to be saddened and heartbroken by the loss of a daughter. I know Ms. Tamika Palmer has lost a child. My mother has invested a lot of time and energy into me, and I know if something happened to me, she would certainly be heartbroken as well as I'm sure Ms. Palmer is feeling. So our continued sympathies and condolences go out to her. I'd also like to say to all those involved in this case, you have my commitment that our office is undertaking a thorough and fair investigation. This is also a commitment I'm making to the Louisville community, which has suffered tremendously in the days since March 13th, to the men and women of our law enforcement community who put on their uniforms every day to protect and serve our communities, and to the peaceful protesters who have used their voice in an effort to seek positive change, who have not given in to calls for violence and looting. To those across the country we've heard from with cards, emails, and letters, and calls, who are asking us to complete the investigation as soon as possible. We hear you, and we are working around the clock to follow the law to the truth. Everyone involved in this case deserves nothing less. By way of background, and as an understanding of how our office got involved in this case, on March 13th, during the execution of a warrant by LMPD, Ms. Taylor was shot and killed in her home. 2 months later, on May 13th, our office was asked to serve as special prosecutor in the case because of a conflict of interest by the Commonwealth's attorney, who at the time was pursuing the prosecution of Kenneth Walker, Ms. Taylor's boyfriend. It's the job of the Attorney General to step in and assist when a prosecutor anywhere in the Commonwealth needs assistance or has a conflict. This case is no different. While Kentucky law provides our office with the authority to appoint a prosecutor from another jurisdiction to oversee the case, we felt that given the importance of this matter, the heavy workload associated with the investigation, and the amount of time that had already transpired since the shooting, our office would proceed with handling the investigation and the prosecution. A few weeks after being asked to serve as special prosecutor, our office began to receive material from the Louisville Metro Police Department's Public Integrity Unit, which was already in the process of conducting an investigation into the events involving Ms. Taylor's death. We have continued to receive information from PIU, and each time we do, we review the materials immediately. Please rest assured that we are also undertaking our own independent investigation to determine the truth. We believe that the independent steps we are taking are crucial for the findings to be accepted both by the community and by those directly involved in the case. An investigation of this magnitude, when done correctly, requires time and patience. I'm under the impression and understanding that I'm not the first to ask for these considerations nor seek them in this case. However, I can assure you that at the end of our investigation, we will do what is right. We will find the truth. I urge everyone watching, regardless of your opinions and beliefs, to do the same. Violence and lawlessness will do nothing more than perpetuate further tragedy. We have the full resources of our Office of Special Prosecutions and our Department of Criminal Investigations involved in this investigation. Our team of investigators and prosecutors with more than 200 years of combined experience are working diligently on the case at my direction. As the Chief Prosecutor for the Commonwealth, my role and the role of my team is very different than that of a civil or criminal defense attorney. I have a specific obligation to see that anyone accused of a crime is accorded procedural justice and that guilt is decided upon the basis of sufficient evidence rather than public opinion. I take this responsibility very seriously. The Supreme Court has said that the prosecutor's interest in a criminal prosecution is not that it shall win a case, but that justice shall be done. A prosecutor may prosecute with earnestness and vigor, and indeed he should do so. But while he may strike hard blows, he is not at liberty to strike foul ones. We are not going to strike foul blows in this case. We are going to pursue the truth based upon the law, whether that lands to convictions or exonerations. Because we need the flexibility to fully investigate the facts, I'm not going to provide a specific date that our investigation will be concluded. However, I can assure you that we understand the urgency, we understand the public outcry, and we understand the need for the truth and the desire for justice. In a moment, I'll take a few questions regarding my comments today. I'll be as transparent as possible in my responses, but please keep in mind that I and my team are bound by ethical rules from the Supreme Court regarding the public comments that we can make in this case. We cannot make statements that will in any way prejudice possible proceedings and risk jeopardizing the investigation. I appreciate your time and attention, and I'm now ready to answer any questions that you might have. Thank you. Well, I'm not going to get into the specifics of what we have specifically, but we are reviewing everything that the Public Integrity Unit has been providing to us. I know there were some comments earlier, previously made by Mayor Fisher that indicated that we had everything. We have been receiving things incrementally, along with conducting our own independent investigation. We continue to receive things from the Public Integrity Unit. And recognize the importance of our office undertaking its own investigation as well.
How will your investigation be different from what the Public Integrity Unit did?
Well, it'll be separate and independent. We have been conducting it simultaneously with the information that we've been receiving from the Public Integrity Unit. But I think for the credibility and the confidence of the community, it is terribly important that we have an independent investigation in our office. Well, the reason I'm here today is to make sure that you all understand that our office is taking this very seriously. We have done so from the beginning, receiving information from the Public Integrity Unit, analyzing that information immediately, but also undertaking our own independent investigation as well. And I ask for people, as I noted in my comments, to continue to be patient with us as we walk down this path. In my judgment, what the responsibility of the Attorney General, as I sit in this office, is to find the truth and allow the law and the facts to lead to truth. That's what we want in this case, and that's why we've been so meticulous and thorough in this investigation.
And I know you said you can't give like a specific date, but we have a family that's been crying for answers for over 3 months. Can you give us, is there like a deadline you're setting for yourself? Because people are not going to rest, and Louisville protests are happening every day. It's getting worse some days. Are you setting a deadline? Are you expecting like 3 months?
I don't want to get into the specifics of any deadline, but know that we are working very diligently on this case. We are working around the clock to make sure that we can have a thorough and fair investigation, and we are doing so expeditiously.
Is the scope of the investigation going beyond just the three officers who entered Taylor's apartment that night? Other cops who were there, the officers who signed the warrant, is the scope that large?
Our investigation is looking at everything. You also recognize, Joe, that the FBI is involved in this process as well. And so we are undertaking our investigation consistent with our federal partners, but are looking at everything.
Are you guys conducting interviews yourself with the officers, witnesses, and everyone involved?
We are looking at everything in this investigation, and our team is doing an independent assessment. I won't get into the specifics, but we are doing a very thorough investigation.
Who in your office is handling the investigation? investigation and how involved will you be?
Well, I get updated regularly. We have regular meetings on it, but we've got a team of prosecutors with over 200 years of experience combined, collectively, that are working on the case.
Does your involvement make you think that there needs to be some kind of statewide change in how officer-involved shootings are handled?
Well, look, I don't want to get into any policy considerations. This is obviously a conversation about the investigation, informational only. I'll let others, while I'm in the position of being the prosecuting authority on this case, I'll let others sort of opine about the policy decisions that need to be made going forward.
Can you explain what's taking so long? I mean, is it still waiting for more materials from the PIU, but why are people still waiting?
Well, we are trying to undertake a very thorough investigation. As I noted earlier, we have received information from the Public Integrity Unit, also running our own independent investigation. And it takes time. I know I'm here in part today to ask for Louisville in particular, but the Commonwealth more generally, for patience as we go through this and recognize that as I sit in this role as Attorney General, that it's important that we get this right and that we do a thorough and fair assessment of all the facts that we receive before we make any sort of determinations. Well, look, I think it's important to note that they have conducted their part of the investigation, but to give additional confidence to the community at large, I thought it was also important that we undertake an independent investigation as well. So I won't get into specifics about the content of the information that they provided us, but we've received it, looked at it, scrutinized it, analyzed it, but also made independent steps as part of an investigation that the Department of Criminal Investigations, which is under my purview, that we're conducting.
As far as you know, though, their investigation is still also ongoing. Correct?
We continue to receive information from them.
Can you describe at all the kind of information that's still outstanding that you're waiting on?
Just to not compromise the investigation, I will decline to answer that. But know that we are receiving information from them. We are asking for additional follow-up on specific items if we have them. And they've been very helpful in providing us that information. But at the same time, again, for the confidence of the Commonwealth of Kentucky, for the entire Commonwealth, all 120 counties, we are conducting our own independent investigation simultaneously with the information that we receive from the Public Integrity Unit.
Do you have a gauge on just the volume of other evidence that's out there that you still need to collect in regards to kind of how far along?
I don't want to get into the specifics of that, but we continue to receive follow-up details from the Public Integrity Unit and continue to do our own work as well.
How much feedback has your office received about this case from letters, calls, people calling in and asking?
Well, as I noted earlier, we've certainly received a lot of information and a lot of calls and letters and emails on this case. It's garnered a lot of attention, which is understandable. And so we are aware of that. We are sensitive to it. And just like I ask every Kentuckian to be patient with us, even those folks from out of the Commonwealth that have expressed an interest in this case, I ask for their patience as well.
Speaking of letters, sir, you did recently get a letter from Beyonce. Now, what do you think about that? Did that move you a certain way or make you feel a certain way that you got a letter from a celebrity now?
Well, whether it's a celebrity or a Kentuckian or any interested party, I take great care and concern in every letter that we receive and completely understand the interest that is surrounding this case. It doesn't matter who sends me a piece of mail. It won't have any bearing ultimately on the case. What our responsibility is to the facts and the law, and that's what will guide us. In the role of Attorney General, I've often talked about this a lot, we have a responsibility to the facts and the law. And I'll certainly do that and dispense with that responsibility regardless of how it ultimately impacts how people view this office.
Based on the evidence that you have seen, do you think it's proper that the officers involved are still employed and being paid everything?
I'm not going to get into specifics of any evidence that we've seen.
You talked about the collective experience of your team. What about you yourself, sir? Have you ever been in this position before? Have you yourself experienced being in this trial position such as this?
Well, we've got a strong team. One of the things that was incredibly important, as you might recall, when I came in, is getting a strong team around that was ready to handle and address these sorts of issues, which is why I'm proud of the fact that we've got prosecutors on this case and investigators on this matter that have over 200 years of combined experience.
Do you feel any added pressure about this case from the racial aspect of it?
Well, look, at the end of the day, we have a responsibility to the facts and the law to get this right for every single Kentuckian. Obviously, there is sensitivities to this case because of everything that's going on in this country. But at the end of the day, my responsibility is to make sure that we get it right, which, to go back to your question originally, is why we are undertaking such a thorough and fair investigation, why we have enlisted the help of Department of Criminal Investigators in our office to help with an independent investigation as well, to help with making sure that the Kentucky, all 120 counties, have confidence that we are doing this in the way that I think you expect of this office.
Is it worrying you that the decision that this office makes will likely have a ripple effect, obviously, in Louisville? People are waiting anxiously for this decision, and if it's not the decision they want, that we could see large crowds out in our streets again, or if it is the decision they want, that police could have a real problem with it?
Well, you know, at the end of the day, the responsibility is great in the Attorney General's office to make decisions regardless of what the what ultimately might be the outcome or the effect of that decision. I am sensitive to that. I recognize it. But what I've tried to share with people is that we are going to do everything we possibly can to make sure that at the end of the day, everyone knows that we've run a thorough and fair investigation, that we've been meticulous in our assessing the information that we have, that we've gone about an independent investigation. And I hope that all 120 counties, Jefferson County, Louisville specifically, will recognize that we are doing everything we possibly can to ensure confidence in this process, to know that from the top down, we're working diligently around the clock to make sure that this process is fair to all. I think that's what you expect of your Attorney General, is that we be fair in the arbitration of this this decision, and ultimately the chips will fall where they may. But I have a responsibility, along with our team, to be fair in the assessment of the facts before us.
One more question.
The 200 years of experience, how many employees does
that? We've got roughly 6 or 7 people on this case.
Thank you all.
Thank you all very much.